talking to you. You connect to the net, right? Well, I wouldn't if I were in your shoes. Corporations say the new net is safe and secure. That they've learned from past mistakes. From opening their ivory towers, everything must look all nice and pretty. But they're wrong. The net is just a rusty car with a fresh coat of paint, a heap of dog shit spritzed with perfume. The demons we released into the net have not gone anywhere. Deadly viruses, artificial intelligences that exist only to...
Stay here in camp. I want patrols every half hour, reporting directly to me.
Are we preparing for a visit from Biotechnica? Or a fourth...
V, you're here.
What is he doing here? I forbade you from even breathing on that Militech convoy, so you call in your friend? To do it all behind my back? Is that it?
Uh-huh. That's exactly why I had V come...
Got no fucking clue what's going on here.
Damn it to hell, Saul. Are you seriously considering letting that basilisk slip through our fingers?
I am.
But a chance like this?
A chance at what?
Get the sense this fight's grown stale. Come on, put some feeling into it.
No. This discussion ended long ago. The Biotechnica people will be here in an hour. Try not to cock anything else up before then.
Come in, Alvacaldos.
I can't believe it. Look, there he goes, off to paint the grass green.
I thought the Biotechnica contract had withered and died.
Saul insists we see it through to the end. To prove the Aldecaldos keep their word.
Crop protection! Who gives a damn about crop protection? All Saul is going to prove is that a corp can walk all over us. And we'll say thank you and ask for more.
What's this basilisk nonsense?
It's an armored Militech cargo panzer. Junk from back in 2060 or so. They want to peddle it off to a backwards country, somewhere it can still pass as a technological wonder.
The Militech convoy will take the 101 right past us. Shame not to say hello.
Let me guess. Whole thing's your idea.
How did you know?
Saul wouldn't be quite so pissed if it weren't.
I believe V is right. If this had been Saul's idea, he would have seen it as the greatest plan on God's green earth.
Bull. Saul isn't that petty. He's simply a coward. He would rather play it safe, bide his time.
Hello, hello.
For the family.
This is Coyote. Just a heads up.
Is this basilisk worth another fight with Saul?
Yes, a craft like that would finally put us back on the right path.
The family is falling apart. If we fall into this Biotechnica rut, no one will ever take us seriously again.
Okay, so you do want to go behind Saul's back and drag me here specifically for that.
Cassidy, Ted, Carol, and Bob also on board.
Thought you and Saul agreed to bury your carbines.
So did I. But it seems that's only true when somebody is trying to kill us.
Exactly. You saved his life. You want to fuck things up all over again now?
I saved his life, yet somehow he still ignores everything I say. So I do believe we have come full circle.
Why Saul got his briefs in a bunch over this basilisk?
He's afraid Militech will destroy us if we pick a fight with it.
He thinks it's safer to stick with the corporations, like Biotechnica. What a joke.
You guys would rather...
We would rather go back to plying the trade we know best. Logistics.
Meaning smuggling.
That's what I said.
Remember a while back, you told me to give you a solid kick in the pants if I saw you diving in the stupid pool again.
I do. Yet that was before our tandem raid on the Raffin camp. I believe you lost your opportunity there.
Nope. Different that. Rescue mission. Someone from the family. Now, you're out to plain trick 'em.
If you plan to lecture me, you can damn well go right now.
And you plan to grab the basilisk how?
Thanks, V.
Haven't said I'd help just yet.
Okay, let's go talk to the rest.
So, just the four vets on board with the plan. Nobody else?
We didn't bother asking the others.
There was too great a risk someone would take it to Saul.
Besides, only the vets understand what we have to gain by having a basilisk.
Sounds pretty risky to me.
On the contrary, easy as pie. There won't even be much security on the convoy. Plus, we'll be doing our part towards furthering the cause of world peace. Why should this beast wind up being used in some little third-world skirmish? We'll make better use of it right here in America.
Did you try to get Saul on board again? No luck, huh?
No. Okay, everyone listen. Militech will transport the Basilisk and parts distributed across two trucks.
Wait, do I sense a quiver in your voice?
Fuck you! The convoy will halt at the railroad crossing on the 101. We'll attack from behind, then get the hell out and away. Questions? Comments? Motions?
Nice job, Sunshine.
Mm-hmm. Damn short, sweet, and pertinent.
Pan Am's got a beef with Saul, I know. But you guys...
A few years back, nobody would have given Corporal Work a second thought.
We want a good name. We just need good gear and good jobs. And Saul would see that if he pulled his head out of his caboose once in a while.
It's all too easy, convenient to arrange. The exact tech you need, coming your way almost served on a silver platter.
Yes, Saul also claimed it stinks to high heaven.
Intel on the convoy, where'd you get it?
Carol hacked the Militech comms channel. Is that enough for you?
Okay, I'm in.
Okay. Thanks. First, we'll ride to the station. The train engine we need to block the convoy's way is there. Are you riding with us, or will we meet you there?
Riding with you.
Excellent. Let's get going.
I think I heard a little shake in that voice.
You did not.
Come on. Did you get your hands clammy, too?
Screw you.
But are you sure you didn't leave any tracks? Militech won't notice a thing.
Trying to insult me, Bobby?
Okay. Forget I even asked.
Let's go.
Nobody's gonna notice you gone back at camp?
Saul has no wish to see us there anyway. The better to make a good second impression on the Biotechnica suits.
Your sour faces wouldn't help much.
Indeed, they would not.
Rathans, what about them? Expecting any trouble?
Saul is. He's posted sentries all around the camp.
How's that not right?
He's wrong in continuing to fight the symptoms rather than the disease.
You don't miss life in Night City?
At times, perhaps. I miss the feeling of having a new beginning, of freedom. But I also haven't forgotten the emptiness. The feeling of realizing it means nothing if you're alone.
Had a hard time leaving my family, too. I was never completely alone, either.
You had someone?
A true friend. Jackie by name. You would have liked him, actually.
Jackie. I remember that. We have arrived.
Big bastard.
If you like it so much, maybe we should just hijack the train. Let the basilisk go on its way.
Yeah, then just drive this beast to the 101. There and back.
Saul would be on board with that.
Are we ready? Okay. The Militech convoy will be traveling from Night City to the base where they're due to meet the buyer. We will stop it at the railroad crossing.
All we have to do is shove this beauty in its way.
V, any questions?
Seems to be a lot of abandoned stations around.
This one belonged to a corporation that ran a cement factory. They use it as their reloading point.
They didn't take the train engine when they left?
The engine's been here going on 40 years, since the Blackwall days.
For a time, everybody had to go back to the old ways. This engine ran on nuclear, like submarines do.
All the weirder they left it behind.
Corpse. They probably listed it in a spreadsheet as cost optimization.
It's old tech. Carol will have to hack it.
Then I'll somehow have to finagle authorization from the control tower to move it.
Tower looks inactive to me, too.
Yeah, we'll see to that. You and Pan Am just get the authorization code.
Okay, let's get to work.
Need a hand?
Of course. But in your shoes, I would look for another way in first. My, that was quick. The stairs it is, then. Thank you.
Let's set to work. I've always been fond of trains. And the stations where so many tracks converge.
Junctions.
Yes, those. When you see them from above, you feel...
free. Like you could set off on 1,000 journeys all at once.
Perhaps more simply, hopeful. Okay, here we are. Carol! What are we looking for? What cards?
Not here. Some sort of Stone Age control panel.
Let's find the cards first.
Got something.
Good job. Carol! We have a card! What now? You have to put it in the reader!
Well, V? The card. In the reader?
Here goes nothing.
It worked! Come look!
Little engine that could.
V, I wanted to speak with you. V? Is this a bad time?
Pretty bad.
Oh, well, this means... Oh, wait, just wait. This is not how we usually talk.
No time like the present.
Okay. Go ahead. That was a joke. Listen, V. I believe I know where this is going.
And not to your liking?
No, it's not that. I also wish to talk about it, just not so openly. My plan was to tiptoe around, test the waters, then retreat back into my shell.
Sounds like a plan. What went wrong?
It seems you saw right through me.
Didn't have a clue how you'd react. You're not the only one shooting in the dark.
I would not want to cock this up.
Well, that's a start.
The thing is, I usually act before I think.
Uh-huh, noticed.
I know. But I also need impulses to act upon. When I do something spontaneously, I feel I'm being honest. Yet with you, I prefer to play it safe.
Why is it any different with me?
Because I truly care this time. Yet I fear I'll do or say something foolish and be left alone in the desert. I would rather keep you close, if only as a friend.
Try following the impulse next time.
Okay. Well, in any case, you've been warned. All right. Let's rejoin the others.
Convoy. Got eyes and ears on it?
Yes. Carol checks their communication channels from time to time. Everything is proceeding as planned. For now.
Still check.
Put your ass down a minute, honey. And breathe.
Everything's under control. The convoy is already.
Haven't heard of any cyber-psycho attacks lately. I think it's time we put an end to our little arrangement. Drop on by sometime. We'll catch up in person.
You worried about Saul?
Acting spooked. As if you're the first person ever to stand up to Saul.
Oh, save your breath. I don't need to be consoled. Was it someone I know?
New. Scorpion.
He came home from the war, head full of new ideas, and a host of new contacts.
He tried to get Saul to lead us in joining Snake Nation. It would make us stronger, he said.
I don't think he peeped a word of it to me. What did Saul do?
Saul dressed the guy down head to toe for messing with the family. Hell, he didn't send him on any jobs for a year.
Gee, really consoling. Thanks.
You said yourself you didn't need any.
Saul was right about Snake Nation. You should remain independent. Otherwise, you could end up like...
like the backers. We'll manage just fine on our own. All we need is a few good jobs. To get people talking about the Aldecaldos again.
And that's why we're here today.
Scorpion would be proud.
Ought to raise a glass to Scorpion.
To Scorpion.
And to Jackie.
Talk about the war much.
What's there to say? They just packed you into a panzer down in Mexico and said full speed ahead, soldier.
And it was weeks talking either to yourself or the onboard AI, drinking iodide like water because your Geiger wouldn't shut up.
I'm sprouting a rash on my ass just thinking about sitting in that boiling hot coffin.
But you all can't wait to pack your asses into the Basilisk, huh?
That's different.
Completely different. You'll see once you're on board.
Get some sleep.
Okay. It'll be quite some time before the convoy comes through.
Growing kind of cold out here.
Not true. But this is nice.
Catch some shut-eye with me.
I'll just lie here a while. Fireside. Gazing at the stars.
Is that another area of your expertise? You got maps of the heavens in your library, too?
Of course. That's the Big Dipper. And do you see the small flickering star to the right?
Yeah.
You do? Oh dear. That means there's a major leak. Good night, V.
Okay, here they come.
Is everyone ready? Let's ride, V. Get her up to speed.
They're going faster than we thought. I don't know if we can catch them.
Uncouple one of the cars. It'll speed you up. Hey, no hemming and hawing. Take out that coupler.
We're getting close. There's the snow.
Hey, shoot out the damn coupler.
Boss.
All right, the train's leaving. We better move.
Okay, let's
ready
go.
Ready to roll.
Fuck, it worked!
Woohoo! Of course it did! Just as I said it would.
How's it going there, V? Did you have fun?
Sure did.
Just be happy you won't be around to put the hunk of junk together. The real fun is just starting bitching Teddy.
Lost the Militech channel. Switch
finally realized someone was listening and changed the codes.
Perfect timing, if you ask me.
So it begins.
What's the meaning of this?
Exactly what you see. The Basilisk.
All I see is two trucks with giant Militech logos on them. Fuck, Pan Am! You can see them from miles away! You think we don't have problems enough on our hands? The Raffens could rear their heads at any moment! And now we have Militech to worry about, too!
Stop it! Fuck! Just shut up already! Do you want to serve corporations forever? Fine, go right ahead. In that case, we'll leave the Basilisk as a souvenir of what this family used to be. Or you know what? Maybe next time we're attacked, we'll be able to fight back!
As soon as I'm done with Biotechnica, we call a family meeting to discuss this. Discuss you. Until that time, I want these trucks out of my sight.
And the Basilisk? Can we put it together?
Do what you want. Just get out of my sight.
Bob, Mitch, you two take the trucks around back. We need to unload.
Sure, but then what do we do with them?
Oh, I've got an idea.
You got quite a pair of lungs there.
Thanks. I believe the last time I pulled something like that, I was 10 years old.
Seems to still be in fine working order. Everything okay?
Yes, of course. Though the great train robbery bit of this was much more enjoyable.
Family's with you on this, I think.
Sure. Where did you get that impression? All I heard was silence.
Saw them looking at that basilisk, drooling. Nomads, panzers, panzers, nomads. It happened from the start.
We'll see.
Need me again, all you gotta do is call.
V, I'm sure I will, so you'd better expect that call.
Be waiting. Take care.
Hey, V! Come here!
Hey, Mitch. You doing okay?
Yeah, I'm doing all right, but, meh. So many dead. So many of them good friends, too. Do you know what it's like to lose your best friend?
Yeah. Name was Jackie.
Uh-huh. How'd he go?
Like everyone goes in Night City.
Anyway, come on. Help me out with something.
What?
Some loose ends. Final goodbye. I don't much want to do it alone.
Okay, I'll help.
Come on, then. You're okay behind the wheel, right?
Yeah, and?
We're going for a drive.
Uh-huh. And where?
You've been in the city a while, haven't you? You want to know everything now, yesterday. A little patience, V. Now, I don't know how it was in your clan, but in the Aldecaldos, everything stays in the family. Used to be Scorpion's, that rig. Now she belongs to me, and my old girl's right next to it.
Nice wheels. Both of them.
Damn right. Out here, those wheels are our life. I'll take Scorpion's, you hop in the other.
Why don't we just take one?
Because we need two.
Shit. You're about as useful as a data term helpline.
You'll see, V. Trust me.
Seriously, where are we going?
One of Scorpion's favorite spots. I owe him one, V.
All right, let's go.
Let's hit the road. Follow me.
Mitch, you hear me?
Yep. But more driving, less talking.
Sun on my face, wind in my hair. Perfect.
Oh, hey. Haven't seen you in a while.
Not a fan of funerals.
Yeah. You and death don't really mix.
Say that like it's my fault. Never asked Saburo to put me on that fucking chip, or for you to slot it in your head.
I hope this place isn't too far.
Speaking of, where are we going?
Not a clue.
My, what a good little boy scout. So trusting, so accommodating.
It's for Scorpion. His last wish or something. Is that good enough for you?
Great. Never a dull moment.
We're heading for the collapsed bridge. Other side of that hill.
Copy. Okay, copy.
Here we are. Go ahead, kill the engine.
Holy shit, Mitch! What the hell?
Relax, V. It's what Scorpion wanted.
He wanted you to stuff him in the trunk like a spare tire?
No, he wanted me to take him here and send him off with a bang.
We set him up behind the wheel, douse the car, then light it, let him fly off the edge.
Saul won't like this. Blasting a good car, it's a terrible waste.
I'll tell him it was an accident.
Grab me that can, will you?
Here you go.
Great. Go ahead. Put it in the passenger seat.
I see the driver is already behind the wheel.
No point wasting time. Another hour or two, and he'll puff up like a balloon. Right. Shall we get this show on the road?
Are you absolutely sure this is a good idea?
No, V. No, I am not. But it was my best friend's dying wish. So I'll do whatever the fuck I can to make it happen. With or without you.
Let's do it.
Hell yeah. I already got a rag in the can. You light it. I'll start the car.
She's burning! Quick, before she blows!
May the road be kind to you, friend. Out with a bang. Just like he wanted. Soot and ash. That much remains. So, how about a beer?
Sure. I'll drink to a send-off like that.
Well, come on. Ah, nothing like a good cold one.
Agreed.
Hey, speaking of, where'd that nickname come from? Scorpion.
Funny. You know, I haven't the slightest idea. Never asked him.
He is Scorpio or something?
Maybe he had a big stinger. Ah, Scorpion, you old bastard. I'm gonna miss you, man.
Mitch, why me? Why'd you ask me to help?
Oh, you seem like a good egg.
I'm serious.
I don't know, I guess the fact that I'm still here to send him off right. That's thanks to you. Your paths crossed. Just for a moment. But damn, was it the right one? Listen, there's a few things of his you ought to have. Like this little good luck charm. Go on, it's yours.
What is it?
Not a clue. Scorpion always had it on him, no idea why. Listen, I'm gonna sit here for a while, all right? Brood in peace.
Understood. I'll be off then.
Sure. Listen, if you want, you can take my car back to camp. Whatever works for you. Oh, and, thanks, V, for today. And for getting me out of that shit back then, too. You're all right. You're really all right.
All units. Thank you.
can lead a horse to water, but you can't make her drink. Now, I've been trying to work with Iris Tanner for years, but the stubborn mare always brushes me off. Kind requests, the promise of good pay, none of it helped. Always the same response. I don't do biz with fixers. But today she has changed her tune. And why? She's been kidnapped by wraiths. Pettiness aside, if you help her, I bet she will finally toss me a bone. The gig details are attached. Go fetch V.
Ah! The
Took you long enough.
Iris Tanner, I'm supposed to get you out of here. We'd best get a move on.
see my ride out, too.
Is it worth more than your life?
Probably. But I'm not so much of a mood to explain. I'll just get some shut-eye, if you don't mind. Jemai, brother.
Dakota, Iris Tanner, as per your request.
Sister. Cut the bullshit, all right? I'm no one's sister. Just tell me what I have to do. After that, we're even.
Where is your car?
Ask your brother.
V?
Don't V me. It was never part of the deal.
You'll get new equipment. Your fee, V? Thank you for the assistance.
Yes? Talk to me.
I thought nomads were always on the move, but you stayed put.
Yes. They call us statics, but we are also necessary. Somebody must take care of those who come and go.
Yeah, take care of them for the right cut.
Indeed.
Tell me about the Badlands. Not much going on out here, huh?
Au contraire, if you use your eyes and ears. This is an ecosystem. Nomads, rocket ships, corporations, and drifters, they form a complete whole. Remove one part, the delicate balance topples.
Listen, from one Netrunner to another, you got any pro tips you could spare?
Don't see why not. If you're cool with Rogue, you're cool with me. I can sell you a few tricks of the trade from the Bardmoss era.
Rach Bardmoss. The Bardmoss. Tell me you're fucking with me.
Before dropping off the grid, he unleashed a slew of ice-breaking grams and protos in the darkest corners of the net.
I heard how paranoid he was. Any idea what happened to him?
Who knows? But I was able to dig up a few classic Bardmoss relics. Here, let me show you.
Hey, Nix, listen. Found something. Bardmoss's deck.
Mm-hmm. What else you find? Alan Turin's tapes?
Being serious. Have a look-see.
Ooh, running shits. Goddamn, V. Where'd you ferret this out of?
Found it outside town, in a fridge, next to its former owner's rotting corpse.
Bardmoss all the way. Netwatch made him a wanted man when looking in Shanghai, Lahore, Santiago de Chile. While that dog alighted to the net. Wonder how long he'd have kept buzzing those wires if the power hadn't gone out.
Think you can pull anything off it?
Tech's coming apart. Humidity damaged. Encryption on the memcube. Gotta be near Divine.
Spare me the two-step, yes or no?
I can try. Failure, though, is a distinct possibility. Then all data'll be lost. Done and gone.
Think there could be some no longer known vectors on the disk? A data crash-like thing, or rabbits? Cause if so...
Then we pop open a bottle of malignant gin. Painfully aware of the risk I am. But speaking straight, curiosity's consuming me. You feel it too?
No risk, no reward. Get to it.
Okay. Put the deck on the counter. Just
ginger-like.
All yours.
All yours? Oh, V. V, got no sense of reverence. Expect if you found the goddamn Holy Grail, you'd fill it with caramel corn and Pop-Tarts. Now, let's get this show underway. Most data's corrupt, but not all. Password. A dict attack, maybe. Nothing doing. And what about injecting a command?
Ha! We're golden. One more hurdle, but it ought to be as easy as pie.
My, my. Of all people, Bodmaw should have done better.
Dog shit, cat shit, rat shit!
Ideas, V, fast and stat. A couple of minutes and his skull sponge will be well done steak.
Okay, what do we got here?
Saw what we got. A brain broiler. You absolutely sure you want to jack in?
Shh.
God damn it! Gotcha.
Fuck a muffin.
You breathing?
Apparently. It feels like I got a skull full of hot embers. Just... what the hell happened?
You started convulsing. Lights went out. Outlets started spitting sparks. So I sat down and finished for you.
Hold up, hold up. Mean to say... you reach Bodmaw's deck? Lowly you?
Damn straight. I am the best net runner in town, after all.
Out it, kid. But maybe someday. Alright. Let's see just what you pulled from this artifact. Logs, mail, chat history of sorts. Potentially interesting. Nothing explosive.
Shame, kinda. Well, I guess I could delve some more, see if I can't find something interesting in there.
Listen. My services usually command a tidy sum, but this time, well, seems you rendered me a service. Take this. Handful of demons live on that shard. Wasn't Vardmas who coded them, but they should be useful nonetheless.
Thanks, Nyx. You gonna get it together? Be all right? Or, you need help?
No, no. Be just fine. Couple of painkillers washed down with whiskey, and I'll be a new man.
Thank you. Too many bottom feeders pouring in from shitholes you never even heard of.
On purpose? search for great leaders, and the Arasaka Corporation answers. Join us today to fight for a better tomorrow. Peace is fragile. Help us strengthen it by using Arasaka soldier systems. Wherever you are, whatever your friends.
The cult hit musical corporate board. Back in theory, dear you.
You're a bitch!
Stick.